So I know most times we get to tell you to create a strong password, do not use a weak password, you let your password have this embedded in them, so and so. But most of us still don't know how to create a strong password. And so in this video, I'll be teaching you how to create a very strong password. Okay, so I'm sure you know this by now. If you don't know, for your password to be tagged a strong password, it must have these four things. It should have a capital letter or an uppercase. It should have a small letter or a lowercase. It should have a special character that is at all these special symbols, okay, like at, and, plus, star, hash sign, all those other symbols. They are called special characters. And finally, you should have numbers. All these things should be in your password for your password to be termed as a strong password. And I mean, it's good, it prevents your account from being hacked, because I'm sure if you don't know, it's only those that are in the cybersecurity field or those that are into ethical hacking and hacking in general that we know that they are what they call word lists and all these password cracking tools that has passwords basically that can just, once they just run those programs, it can get your password. And if your password is weak, if it does not have these things, it will be easy for them to get your password. That's how you get to see, oh, my account has been hacked, blah blah blah. But it's good to just have strong password irrespective of the two-factor authentication and everything. You still need a very strong password, or else you'll still be able to bypass your account or your password and get hacked in the end. So now, without wasting more time, let's go straight into teaching you how to create a strong password. Okay, so you know that in 0 to 9 forms, all the numbers we have, in all the type of numbers we want to have, we have 0 to 9. Okay, in 9000, it's from 0 to 9. Any number, 0 to 9 is the base number, or the basic numbers, or the, should I say, the base of numbers, 0 to 9. Okay, so 0, looking at 0, what alphabet does 0 look like? Did I hear O? Yes. O, letter O looks like 0 in a way, right? Okay, so I'm sure you can see it on the screen. Everything will be on the screen. So the letter O looks like 0. So now the next number is 1. What letter looks like 1 if it's capitalized? I, right? Good. I looks like 1. So what about 2? I don't think any letter looks like 2. 2 is a very strange number. What about 3? Okay, 3, you might say no letter looks like 3, but E, letter E looks like 3. The capital letter E, I mean, looks like the number 3. The capital letter E looks like number 3. Just that it's inverted. Okay, what of number 4? Number 4, perhaps nothing, but in a way, the capital letter A looks like, almost in a way, not exactly, looks like number 4. So what of number 5? Is anyone? Yes, you guessed right. S. The letter S looks like number 5, okay? What of number 6? Is there anyone? I don't think so. I don't think there's any letter that looks like number 6. What about number 7? Yeah, someone just said. So what about number 7? Yeah, you thought right. The letter T looks like number 7. I mean, the capital letter T looks like number 7, as you can see on your screen. What about number 8? Is there anyone that looks like number 8? Can you guess? Well, you are correct. If you said B, the capital letter B looks like 8 in a way, okay? And what about 9, which is the last number we have there? Well, P can look like 9, or Q can look like 9, no matter the way, it depends on the way you want to do it. So P and Q can look like 9. Okay, so let me show you how this works, or how you can use this. For example, if you're, and remember I said for your password to be strong, it must have an uppercase, a lowercase, a special character and a number. For example, now your name is Precious. I want to use Precious. Let's say my name is Precious and I want to use Precious as my password. I can't just use Precious because that's going to be a very weak password and a very funny password to use. I can't just use Precious as my password. I'm Precious, and let's say my best numbers are 1234. If they tell me to choose a number for a pin, and I want to use 1234, which I will not advise you, never use 1234 as your pin. If it's very easy to guess, but for example, those are my best numbers and my name is Precious, I somehow want to add 1234 to my password. Since you said I can add numbers to my password to make it strong, so I have letters, which is my name Precious, and I have numbers, so perhaps I just need one special character or two. What special character do I want to use? Let me see. Maybe I want to use plus. I can use plus, right? So Precious plus 1234 is what I want my password to look like, but I don't just want to use Precious, okay? So what do I do? looking at what we said earlier, does P look like any of the numbers? Yes, P looks like 9. So instead of writing P for the pressures, we can use 9 to replace it. Next one there is R. There's no number that looks like R, so we can just leave it as. For E, which is in pressures, we can use number 3 instead of using the E. Okay, we can use number 3. For C, nothing is like C, so we can leave C the way it is. For the O, which comes next after the I, which we use as number 1. For the O, we'll use what? We can use 0. And then for the U, we'll use U like that. For the S, you can either use number 5 or the dollar symbol. Okay, that's if you want. You can use number 5 or the dollar symbol. So you can see what my password looks like right now. You can see what my password looks like. It's not the generic precious plus 1234. So it is this plus 1234. So there is no how someone wants to guess this password at all. Even if someone is using any cracking software or any cracking tool, it will be difficult for the person to actually get this password. Okay, so you can use this to create any type of password you want. For example, too, I might want to, okay, I'm registering for, I'm registering for Canva. And I want to use a different password, because you can't be using the same password on all your platforms. It's better to always use different passwords in case this one is compromised, in that maybe they have a data breach or something. So you have to use different passwords across all platforms. But for you to remember, it's quite easy. For example, now I want to register in Canva. I want to log in or have a password in Canva. If I still want to use my name, I can use Precious Loves Canva as my password. But remember, for you to use it, you can't just write Precious Loves Canva. You can now change some of those letters to numbers, and then you can put one of these special characters to make it unique in a way that nobody can ever guess it. Okay, so I will show you, I'm sure you can see some examples of a password and how they were changed using this format which I just taught you now. So hopefully with this format, you won't be setting a weak password. You won't just use your name as your password, or your mom's name as your password, or your best, or your past school as your password. You won't use all those things as your password with this that you've learned.
So this is an added clip to the video. You might not be able to keep lots of those passwords in your head when you have a whole lot, because some of us are using so much social media platforms. So if you are using about 12 different social media platforms, you might not keep a lot of those passwords in your head. So it's advisable you use what they call password managers. So password managers help you to keep your password, so you don't need to remember it or keep them in your head. All you need to do is you have one master password to lock the main password manager application, then other passwords are already stored in that particular password application. So there's a link below in the description. You can use it to download this password manager. And if you don't know what a password manager is, or if you need more details, there's also a link in the description to tell you about what a password manager is and how it can be used. Okay, so let's continue the video.
If you have better ways which you would like to teach us, you can comment below in the comment section, and then we'll hear from you and perhaps share it with others. But this is a good way to tweak your password. It could be anything, but make sure you understand the basics towards creating passwords like this. And with that, hopefully you will never forget your password. Okay, with this you'll be able to create strong passwords, easy to remember passwords, and you will always be safe online. So thanks for watching this video. If you are new to this channel, I'm sure you've clicked on the subscribe button by now. If you have not, just smash the subscribe button there, and also give us a like for this video. And then finally, share this video to everyone. Let them learn to create a strong password. So you can enjoy our videos up here. We have lots of videos here. Click on any of them, enjoy them. We have lots of interesting content for you and your friends. So do well to enjoy and share. Stay safe.